the reason why I wanted to talk to you is because I don't see a lot of people of color in these protests. They're coming.
Yeah.
But why do you think black
are
and brown?
Are we recording now?
Yeah. Why do you think black and brown people are not participating as much?
Well, the reason why I feel that our people are not participating, people of color, ethnicity, immigrants, we're not here because we don't know about it. You understand? Because the media does not want us to know about it.
Do you think it has anything to do with fear? People are afraid maybe of being incarcerated?
No, it's not even about being afraid. It's about knowledge is power. If you have no knowledge, you shall perish. If you have no vision, you shall perish. So what this movement is all about is unification, humanitarian. I and I is born through a line of slavery, and I come from a line of people that are strong in Jamaica, the West Indies, the Caribbean. And we want the people to know that if you stand up for your rights and get up and stand up against the wrongs, then you shall have something for the future. This is what our people fought for, so don't be afraid, because if God is with you, no man be against you.
And this protest is, like you said, about humanity. It's not about nationality, so against certain country. It's about justice. What do you tell those people who still think that protesting on the streets have no effect whatsoever in the system? Do you think this is going to cause an impact?
I believe this will cause an impact, because look at this. It's not just whites, it's not just blacks, it's not just Chinese, it's not just anyone. It's humanitarians coming together for one cause. We are the 99% of people that get shitted on and get nothing, my friends. Nothing we get. The 1%, this is Wall Street we're about. They are the ones that holding on to the money, and the rich getting richer and the poor getting poorer. And we can make a change. No medical coverages, no dental coverages, no vision coverages. Prescription drugs are higher than ever. How can you survive off of your minimum wages?
And then you have housing, education, everything.
Exactly. You have a house to pay for, you have a car note, you have insurance, you have kids to put through college, you have this different things that you gotta worry about. Transportation, the MTA raised their fares on us. How can we afford to get to work, buy food, and supply for our children?
What about those people who want to join but they cannot come to New York, or they don't necessarily want to be on the street? What can they do in order to change?
What you can do is organize a small group from a small, one man has a vision and can follow, everyone shall come together. If everyone comes together and does their part, then this can be a massive worldwide movement. But it starts here at home in the US. If we as a people can organize our veterans, our seniors, our young adults, and our children, and bring us all together, no matter where you come from, we can make a change, my friends.
One of my friends say that he doesn't want to come because he heard in the news there has been some beatings and detention. Are you afraid of being detained?
I am not afraid. The only man I fear in this life is God, and may the Lord be with me and all of our people that have died for us to have this moment, my friends. Do not be afraid of the hours that the enemy shall come, because even they have to face one judge. They have to face the judge as well. So my friends, united we stand and divided we fall. The Constitution is for us, not against us. The laws of today are showing that it's unjust, but we must bring justice so we can have peace.